I was recently asked what is the better theme framework or page builder between Beaver Builder and Divi, and I want to answer that in this video, and this video might be a little longer than most people would want, but if you're looking to maybe purchase and make an investment into Beaver Builder or Divi, this video is going to be worth it to you to just watch it and get some perspective on it. Now, on the surface, they're similar. They're page builders and they have themes available. But in life, as in most things of life, it's not so simple and it can be a little complicated because they're both, even though they are page builders, they're actually very, very different. And the difference isn't just the price. For instance, Beaver Builder is a little bit more expensive. If I'm on their site right now, their package that's comparable to what you get with Divi is going to cost you $199. And what that's going to do is it's going to give you their theme and their plugin. $99 just gets you their plugin only with a year of support and updates. And they don't have a lifetime option. When you look at Divi, it's here's their three options. You can get Divi for $69 for the first year. If you look there on the bottom right, there's a 10%. They always have this 10% off. And from time to time, it's like 20% off. I've seen different discounts. You look here, $69 gets you the Divi, which is their page builder, and the theme. $89 is if you want the plugins that the company makes. And for $249, which is an unbelievable value, you're getting it's a one-time fee, and they're going to give you support. They're going to give you updates, and you can't really get that anywhere. So it's a really good value what you get with Divi. Now, on the surface, one of the main differences between Divi and the difference between Beaver Builder is the way you create your content. And so, for instance, Divi has what's called a back-end page builder. And with Beaver Builder, it's a front-end page builder. So let me show you what I mean by that. Here's a Divi demo. If I go to Pages and I go ahead and click on this page right here that says Home, to use the Divi Builder, I'd have to click on this purple button right here, and I can start building my page now by creating columns and rows and dropping in elements. And this is pretty much how it works. There's some templates with it as well. So if I clicked on Load from Library right here, there's a library of templates. They don't really let you see a thumbnail of it or anything like that, and you can have your own predefined library. So let me just choose, let's just choose a homepage right here, creative agency. That's fine. I click on load, and this is what your typical Divi page builder page is going to look like, and you don't even know what the heck you're looking at. It's kind of lacking the intuitiveness because of this back-end page builder. Now, with Beaver Builder, the experience is totally different. So if I go to Pages, and I have, just like on the other side, I've got this home page. To get into Beaver Builder, I would click on this tab here that says Page Builder, and it's going to take me instead to the front end of the website where everything is visual. It's just loading. We'll give it here a moment. So it does everything visual. So let me start with a template real quick. And so here's their layout templates. You get this nice thumbnail. And unfortunately, at the time I'm making this video, these are the only templates available. But I do know within maybe a month or so, they're going to have a whole bunch of new templates that are really going to take the design up a few notches. But anyways, you've got these here. So let's just go ahead and select one. Let's just go ahead and select this one. Why not? And it's going to take everything and it's going to put it in here. So now you can see it's a totally different experience. I can see things and just, it's completely visual. So I can say, I might want to change this text. And then all you have to do is take your mouse and click in it, because that's what you would intuitively want to do, is click on it. And then right here, I can change whatever I wanted it to say. Just like this, and then click on save. You see how it's intuitive? I can scroll down, and I would intuitively, if I wanted to change this image, I would just click on it. And this is the intuitive nature of Beaver Builder, which allows you to create a site much faster because you're doing it visually. Back to Divi, I can't really see what I want to edit. I can see that this is text, but I don't know what the text says, and I would intuitively want to click on it, but when I click there, that's not where you want, where you need to click. You need to click on this three lines there, and then when I click on it, then I've got this panel that pops up, and then I've got a whole bunch of options. You see the difference there? It's kind of lacking in intuitiveness when you compare it to Beaver Builder. So let's just call this a win for Beaver Builder. It might cost a little bit more, but you're having a much more intuitive web building experience because of it. And in Beaver Builder, you have all these tabs here with different settings, and it's kind of easy to understand what these settings mean. When you look at Divi and you do this, you've got settings that sometimes are not as intuitive to a do-it-yourself or a non-developer. So that's one of your main differences when you compare Beaver Builder to Divi. The theme options, there are a lot of them are going to be the same, like the fonts you use and the menu styles and all that. A lot of those are going to be pretty much the same. A little bit in Divi's defense, even though you don't have the front end page building experience, you have this kind of a quasi page front end page builder. Let me show you what I mean. So say I'm working on this section here. I can go ahead and click right here, and I can click this little eye, and it's going to show me, it's going to generate a preview of what this row looks like. You see right there, it's generating a preview of what it looks on a desktop or a mobile or whatever. It's generating this nice preview for me. So if I'm working on this little text box right here, even though I'm setting it all up, I have no idea what it looks like, I can click on this little eye and it's going to generate a preview. So, I mean, it's not quite the front-end page builder experience of Beaver Builder, but you do get some of it at least, some of that feel. Now, I do want to preface, this is Divi 2.7, and Divi has already, Elegant Themes, the maker of this theme, Divi, has already said that version 3.0 of the Divi Builder is going to be a complete front-end page building experience. So that's important to mention. Okay, so let me get out of here. Now here's the thing that people complain about with Divi. You can't really see what Divi's doing behind the scenes, okay? It's just doing what it does. But if you were to ever stop using the Divi page builder, your content and how pretty it was and how it looked out, it's not gonna look like that. It's not even gonna resemble that even in the slightest. If you were to stop using Divi, it's kind of like once you're in, you're in. Beaver Builder, if you were to stop using Beaver Builder, you would still have all your text and some of the layout and the formatting, so at least you can reformat it. However, I never really saw that as a big deal because most websites might be 5 to 10 pages of content. If you're switching to a new theme or a new framework or new anything, you're going to have to redo all that stuff anyway. So I don't really see that as a big problem. So that's one of the biggest differences between the two different themes and the page building experience. Now, one thing that Divi has that Beaver Builder does not have, and this is a big win for Divi, is they recently added a split testing option feature set into the builder. And to me, in my mind, I don't expect to ever see this built into Beaver Builder. But in my mind, it's actually pretty huge. A huge, huge, huge feature. And what this does is it allows you to implement something called CRO, conversion rate optimization. And that's the process of when someone comes to your website, you're split testing different colors, different text combinations, different layouts. You're able to split test to see which options or which configuration is going to get you to your visitors to take the desired action and outcome that you want. So basically, if you want someone to buy something, you can try so many different things to see what's going to get them to click on the buy button and actually buy. Is it the color of the button? Is it the headline? What is it that's going to lead them to take the action that you want? And the reality is, you, me, anyone building a website, we have no clue what's going to get someone to take the action that we want. We might think, hey, let me say this is the greatest company on earth. You need this service, and that's going to get someone to take the action you want. But the reality is you have no clue what you need to say to someone in order to get the action you want. That's why you need to be able to test it. And when you look at where we are with the internet and websites and web development, we're really in the infancy of it. Every couple of years, the technology gets more and more advanced. Every couple of years, there's more and more offline businesses getting online. And so you want to have the best tools available to you. And this split testing engine, I think, is really a game changer in my mind. And it might be more important and more valuable to you than an easier front page building experience. So you can do the most amazing things. So say this spot right here, I wanted to split test it. All you would have to do is scroll to the very top, click on this little icon here with the three lines that says settings, and we get this little pop-up here, and we can click right here to enable split testing. And we start getting all these different options to enable this split testing on the theme. Once I click this proceed button, I need to select the element of this page that I want to split test. So I'll click on proceed. And let's just say I want to split test this little bit of text right here. So I would click on it right there. And now it's telling me to go ahead and set a goal. So what are we going to measure this against to see if it's a successful test or not? So you would go ahead and click on OK. And say the goal is this call to action. And this call to action is saying, click on this button to view the portfolio. So we can, so essentially this test is going to, we're going to split test this headline to see if the what the headline says can get someone to view, more people to view your portfolio. So I'm going to go ahead and click here, and this is going to be the goal. So I'm going to click on OK, and what it did is it created a second variation. And so we've got variation one and we've got variation two, and you can have more variations if you want. And so what it's going to do is now I can go and change the text in variation two. So instead of our latest work, we can say our very best work or something like that. And what's going to happen is as people visit your site, they're randomly going to be shown this variation, and then they're going to be randomly shown this variation, and it's going to track based upon the variation, how many people that saw variation one clicked on the See Portfolio button, how many people that saw variation two clicked on the See Portfolio button, and which one is the winner, and then you can automatically only use the winner and end your test. And you can split test colors of buttons. You can split test anything that you want. And I really think that this is such a game changer, because what's going to happen is conversion rate and optimization of your website is going to end up being everything as time moves forward and all sales start to migrate onto being web-based. So You can't diminish the value of a split testing engine built into your WordPress theme. And so that is another big difference. And this is a Divi winner all the way. And you can, I'm not really giving this feature justice. You can go ahead and head over to Elegant Themes blog where they talk about this feature called Divi Leads. Now, there's another thing that might give some difference to both of them. Beaver Builder and Divi, they're different, and we need to look at code quality and page load speeds and stuff like that. And I don't have any tests in front of me, but I've read a lot of tests, and Beaver Builder is going to give you faster page load times, which is an important aspect for SEO, and that's Google taking your website and showing it high on their search engine rankings based upon page load speed. Now, I will say though, I don't know how relevant page load speed is because you're going to have to use something called caching on both sites. So you're going to have to use caching on your Divi site or your Beaver Builder site. And we might be only talking like a fraction of a second. So I don't think a fraction of a second makes that much of a difference. And that's just a personal opinion. And I'm sure a lot of people may agree or disagree with me. But I don't really think that the page load speed difference is that big of a deal. So anyways, these are my three big differences between Beaver Builder and Divi. And if I was to answer the question, should you use this one or that one? My answer is going to be, it depends. If you want a more intuitive, faster, enjoyable website building experience and you don't mind paying just a little bit more, get Beaver Builder. You're going to love it, okay? But if you got more time on your hands, you're willing to get a little bit more technical and figure out how something works, and it might not be quite as intuitive, but you know that the front-end page builder's coming, but if you have less money to invest, and the A-B split testing Divi Leads feature is important to you, go Divi all the way, and you'll get the front-end page builder eventually in six or 9 months, probably. So you'll eventually get that. So I really can't answer the question for you. I know for me, I'm building an agency website right now. I'm using Divi for that. However, when I'm in Beaver Builder, I just enjoy the experience a whole lot more. So we'll see what happens when Divi comes out with their front-end page builder. That'll be a good time to reevaluate this video. But the answer is, it depends. Now, if you want Divi or Beaver Builder, I do have links down below, and I'd appreciate if you use my links to go and visit those sites if you're reviewing on which purchase to make for you. Yes, you made it to the end of the video, which must mean that it brought value to you. So can you go ahead and click on the thumbs up down below? That'll help me out. And if you want more videos like this, be sure to click on the subscribe button right down below me. Now, if you want to find me on the internet, I've got a special Facebook group that I set up for people just like you that want answers to their WordPress website. And that's where you can find me, interact with me, and ask me questions. So go ahead and click on the blue button down below to join that special Facebook group. Now, I never want you to leave empty-handed, so I've created a free video course for you called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. In this video course, you're going to really learn how to make your website shine, get the results that you want, and have it really stand out from the crowd. So to access that free video course, go ahead and click on the link over here on the right. You can also find me at WPCrafter.com. Make sure you check out my 60-minute website challenges. Those are very popular, and you can find those on the website as well. Hey, thank you so much for watching this video. I make these videos just for you, and I hope you watch the next one.